हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू सेकंड एमकॉम थर्ड सेम। इन दिस सेम यू हैव आर्टिफिशियल एंड बिजनेस इंटेलिजेंस सब्जेक्ट। दैट सब्जेक्ट इज़ हैंडल्ड बाय मी। दिस इज़ अ न्यू सब्जेक्ट इंट्रोड्यूस टू यू इन दिस सेम। फर्स्ट लेट्स सी द इंडिविजुअल मीनिंग ऑफ दिस वर्ड्स, मीन्स लेट्स सी द मीनिंग ऑफ आर्टिफिशियल business and intelligence. Meaning, artificial. Artificial means what? It means produced by human being rather than occurring naturally. That means the man-made product is called as artificial. Then business. It is a common word, we use it in everyday. Business means it is an activity of buying and selling products in order to earn profit. That means what are the cash transaction taken place in order to earn profit, such transaction or such activity is called as business. Let's see the meaning of intelligence. While hearing this intelligence, what you always use in day-to-day life, right? What he or she is an intelligent student. Albert Einstein was intelligent. Like that, we use it in our day-to-day life. But intelligence meaning we don't know. Intelligence can be defined in many ways. The ability to learn, understand or apply knowledge to deal with new situation. That means it is the ability to acquire and apply knowledge is called intelligence. Let's see the etymology. Etymology means from where the word intelligence is derived. The word intelligence is derived from Latin word intelligentsia or intelligence, which means to understand. The simple meaning of intelligence means to understand. The intelligence is considered like a trait, or it's like a characteristics of a human being, like height, weight, strength. Like that, intelligence is also considered as a trait, and it is mainly related to consciousness, means it is related to our mind or intellectual, because it creates awareness which help us to solve the problem. This intelligence include these different characteristics or different activities: the ability to gather knowledge, to learn, be creative, form strategies, engage in critical thinking. The ability to gather knowledge means what? For example, Bangalore is capital of Karnataka. This is about information. You get this knowledge to learn. To learn means if you go for the driving classes, then what you learn scooty or car driving. That is to learning. Be creative. Be creative means if you are good at in modeling, model making or sketch or drawing, that is a be creative. Form strategies. In order to solve problem, you form some strategies. Engage in critical thinking means you go for the research work or any other work or invention, that is called engage in critical thinking. All these things are considered as intelligence. Intelligence is considered as a basic toolbox, means in human or in any animal, we consider intelligence is very important part. This intelligence include or the process of intelligence are ability to gather information, memory and learning. Ability to gather information. Ability to gather information means it is a information about the world is gathered through five senses like vision, sound, smell, touch and taste. I already told you what Bangalore is capital of Karnataka. This what Bangalore is capital of Karnataka, it is a what? Information. You gather that information. Then next step what? Memory. Means that information you save it in your mind. Then you learning. If it is in future, someone asks which is the capital of Karnataka, then you will tell what it is, Bangalore. That is the process of intelligence. Or for memory means it's a ability to save and recall information. Learning means the process of putting together a sequence of action or thoughts is learning. For example, continuous practice of driving, then itself you become perfect driver or master in the driving. That is the learning. I hope you clear with these three processes: ability to gather information, memory, learning. The simple is intelligence is nothing but you understand the information and use it in the future. This intelligence is most of the time studied in human being, right? We usually, when intelligence word here, we tell it is a human intelligence, right? But it also studied in animals and plants. But in this subject, we concentrating on human intelligence. So the meaning of human intelligence is very important. Let's see the meaning of human intelligence. It is the intellectual power of human which is marked by complex cognitive feats and high level of motivation and self-awareness. Intellectual power means what? Intellectual power nothing but it's related to our mind or mind of human, which is marked by complex cognitive feats. Cognitive feats is nothing but the process of acquiring knowledge and understanding through thought, experience and senses. Means you acquire the knowledge, you acquire the information through the five senses. Or I already told, what are the five senses? Vision, sound, smell, touch and taste. Through this, if you acquire the knowledge and save it in your memory, that is we call as cognitive feats. And high level of motivation, self-awareness. Means through this, all the information you gather, you get what motivation, self-awareness to do some future works. That is we call as human intelligence. Under intelligence, there are different types, or we call it as measures of intelligence. First one is intelligence quotient. Quotient is nothing but measures. Okay, intelligence quotient. This is the measure of your comprehension ability. Comprehension. Comprehension ability. Comprehension means the ability to solve maths, memorize things and recall subject matters. If you go for the bank test, you will get logical test, then mathematical test. That all the things consider as an intelligence quotient. This intelligence quotient can be calculated as MA divided by CA into 100. MA is nothing but mental age. It is mental age. CA means chronological age. Through this formula, you can calculate this intelligence quotient. Then let's see the next one. That is emotional quotient. Emotional quotient means it is a person's interpersonal and communication skill. It is an interpersonal and communication skill. That means it is ability to maintain peace with others, keep time, be responsible, be honest, be humble, genuine, etc. What are the things connected to our emotions? That we call as emotional quotient. Then next one, spiritual quotient. This also called as social quotient. It also called as social quotient. The ability to behave with wisdom and compassion while maintaining inner and outer peace regardless of situation. The ability to behave with wisdom. Wisdom means the quality of being, and compassion means showing sympathy or concern for the sufferings of others. That is called as spiritual or social quotient. That means the ability to build a network of friends and maintain it over long period of time. That means if how many times or how much friends you have or how you behave with your relatives, how you behave with your friends or how you behave with the society, that itself is called as social or spiritual quotient. Adversity quotient. Adversity quotient means the measure of your ability to go through a rough patch in life and come out with losing your mind. Means how if you face a difficult situation, that difficult situation, how you manage it, how you come out of that situation, or if you go if you're suffering from a problem, then how you solve that problem through your decision, that itself is called as adversity quotient. The capacity to live, work and deal with unavoidable situation is called as adversity quotient. Then last type, that is physical quotient. The word itself tells what physical quotient means. The ability to learn, ability to listen, identify and respond to internal messages about one's physical self, means determining our body's weight, fitness level and perfect diet. This all consider what are the measures or what are the things related to our physical or our body, that is we call as physical quotient. I hope you clear with these types and the meaning of intelligence. If you add this intelligence word to artificial and business, then you will get a new concept, that is artificial intelligence and business intelligence. Okay, let's see the meaning of artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence was founded as an academic discipline in 1955, and this AI or AI is a short form of artificial intelligence. This artificial intelligence is considered as a branch of computer science. Okay, it is called as, sometimes this AI also called as machine intelligence. Artificial intelligence also called as machine intelligence. Let's see the meaning of artificial intelligence. It is an area of computer science that emphasizes the creation of intelligent machine that work and react like a humans. What are the means? Artificial intelligence, it's a computer science. I already told it is a branch of computer science. How that emphasizes the creation of intelligent machine that work and react like humans. If what are the things human beings are doing, the same thing are done by the machine, then we call it as artificial. For example, if human beings, what are the things they do? Planning, then organizing, learning, problem solving. If all these things are done by the human beings, if the same thing done by the machine, then it is called as artificial intelligence. It is a intelligence demonstrated by machines, unlike the natural intelligence displayed by humans and animals. What are the activities done by the humans that also be done by the machines? Then such a system is called as artificial intelligence. For example, you used some applications like GPS, then Facebook, then you use Instagram and etc. In all these form of apps, this artificial intelligence are used. For example, in Facebook, when you upload a photo, it recommend to tag your friend, right? Then how the Facebook come to know that is your friend, or they asked us to mention the name, that is because of artificial intelligence. Or if you interest in a particular ad, then it recommend the similar ad in future. These all the things because of what? Artificial intelligence. I hope you clear with the meaning of artificial intelligence. In the coming chapters, let's see it's in the detail. Okay. Next, business intelligence. It is the processes, technologies, and tools that help us to change data into information and information into knowledge and knowledge into plans that guide organization for their decision making. Means it simply, if artificial intelligence are used in a business, then we call as business intelligence. For example, if a business is considered, then what are the activities include? Manufacturing, purchasing, sales, like that. Okay, here what they told, technologies and tools means if you use computer or some application, then such application help us to change data into information. Data into information means I already told, in a business there are different lot of information will get. Okay, that is a raw data. And data into information means if you maintain separate file for sales, separate file for purchase, separate file for manufacturing, then that information means data, raw data into, you convert it into information. You separately maintain all this in separate files. That is a data into information. Then information into knowledge. Because of maintaining separate file, you can get a clean and clear cut idea about how much sales go, how much sales happened, or how much amount purchase you have done, how much units you produced, right? That is the information into knowledge. Then knowledge into plans. Because of that knowledge means due to the results of maintaining different files, how much goods you purchase, that is purchases cost, that from that information you can reduce your costs, means you can forecast the sales or you can reduce your costs. So because of these tools and technologies, you get a clean and clear idea and you can focus about the future and helps the business for their decision making. The simple is, if you use artificial intelligence in a business activities, then we call it as business intelligence. Okay, only this much enough in this video. In the next video, let's study in detail. Means let's start with the first lesson. Okay, thank you. If you not understand any concept, please contact me. Thank you.